What's up guys, today I have got some exciting news about Unichain, a promising blockchain project running its testnet right now. Remember Uniswap? It was one of the biggest projects in history, rewarding early users with $1,000 of tokens. Unichain might offer a similar opportunity, so let's jump into how you can take part and get ready for a possible reward in the future. Unichain is an upcoming DeFi-native Ethereum Layer 2, optimized to be home for liquidity across chains, delivering fast, scalable transactions ideal for decentralized applications. So, let's get right into it. I'll show you all the steps you need to do in this Unichain testnet. Alright, the first mission you need to do in this Unichain testnet is bridge. Before doing this, you must have some Ethereum Sepolia testnet in your wallet, so we can bridge Ethereum from Sepolia testnet to Unichain testnet. If you don't have Ethereum Sepolia testnet in your wallet, don't worry, I'll show you the way to get it. If you already have some Ethereum Sepolia testnet in your wallet, you can just skip this step. So first step you need to do is access Gitcoin passport. Sign in with your Ethereum wallet. Use MetaMask. Scroll down and you will see social platform account. You need to verify your LinkedIn account and Google account to get at least 2 points of humanity score. Then you will be able to use the Ethereum Sepolia faucet. Now you can go to the faucet page, input your wallet address and start mining. Remember, there is a minimum claim condition. Make sure you reach the minimum claim condition to claim the faucet. Keep mining until you reach 1 Ethereum Sepolia, which can be used in this testnet or other testnet as well. So now we are back to the bridge. As you can see in the screen, they have Superbridge and bridge.gg. I'm gonna go with Superbridge first. Connect your wallet, MetaMask. Confirm your login request. And now you can bridge from Sepolia to Unichain Sepolia. I'm gonna go with 0.05. Review bridge. Continue. Accept terms. And now you can start bridging. Confirm your transaction request in MetaMask. Be patient, this step is gonna take few minutes to complete. 3 minutes to go and MetaMask confirmed your transaction. You can see your activity right now. Waiting for confirmation. And now your bridge successful. Okay, now we're going to do the other bridge, bridge.gg. Connect your wallet, same step, just use MetaMask and confirm your login request. Now I'm gonna put the same amount again, it's 0.05. Review transactions. Confirm. Confirm your transaction in MetaMask. And this step is gonna take a while to be patient. Only few minutes. Okay, now your MetaMask confirm your transaction right now. You can close this screen and go to history. It says completed. Now you're going to go to the next step. Okay, so we're here in Owlto Finance. First step you need to do is connect your wallet, MetaMask. And you're gonna need to press deploy. In this step, you're gonna need to deploy your smart contract in Unichain testnet. Add this chain to your MetaMask. And now you can deploy it. Okay, now you are good to go. In this step, you're gonna deploy a contract in Unichain testnet. confirm your transaction request, and add confirm your signature again. Now you can view your contract. Okay, so that's it. Okay, here we are in Zora.co. It's basically an NFT marketplace. What I'm about to do is for content purposes only. I'm not advising you to buy this NFT and I'm not guaranteeing anything. Please do your own research. However, there was many projects in the past have offered airdrops for NFT holders. So the choice is yours. Click buy. You can buy as much as you want. In my case, I'm still gonna buy one. You can choose Ethereum mainnet or Arbitrum one. Switch network to Arbitrum one. The price is less than $1. It should 0.76. Now you can buy it. And here we go. So that's all for today's video. By taking part in Unichain Testnet now, you are setting up yourself for potential reward, even airdrop coins. If you find this content helpful, hit the like button and subscribe for more crypto tips and tutorial. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comment section below, and I'll see you in the next video.